Last class we have completed integer data types. I hope all you people clear, understood every point. So last class we understand explanation on integer data types, comparison with C. We understood explanation on floating point data types. We forgot to consider one point from C language point of view. Floating point, C language point of view, we have forgot to consider one point. Let me complete it. Look at there. Compared to C language, very important point. If you remember, in a C language, you can assign, we can assign, what you call a 10.0 floating point number to a int variable, where in C language we can assign 10.0 to float variable in C language, but in Java compiler will throw error. This topic, yesterday topic, we forgot, just I am recollecting. Int i1 equal to 10.0, float f1 equal to 10.0 in C language allowed, but in Java not allowed. In a C language, this 0.0 is removed, 10 stored in an int variable. In a float variable, 10.0 as it is stored in its format. But in Java, if you want to assign floating point number to float variable, we must suffix float or capital, small f or capital F. Int variable, if you want to assign floating point number to int variable, we must prefix cast operator. Remember? Cast operator we can assign. Then what this cast operator will do, like this, int i equal int of 10.0, if you write, what this cast operator do, cast operator will convert, 0.0 will be removed, only 10 is stored in i2 variable, like this. And in floating point data type, in a floating point data type format, 10.0 stored, double format, double 10.0 will be stored. So this is the point yesterday we have missed it, and I hope you understand. So in C and C++, we can store, but in Java, not allowed. We ought to use cast operator, or we should use prefix data type. That's it. So this is the continuation to yesterday class, floating point number comparison with C language. Can hope everyone understand? Shall I go to next point? Okay. Now, today we will understand char data type. Next data type is char data type. Tell me. Char data type. I am writing one statement here. Is it a char data type? I'm writing char ch equal to a. Come on, tell me. I have written char ch equal to a. Is it a character? No. Here compiler throws error. Cannot find symbol. What? Variable A. Cannot find symbol, variable A. What the meaning of it? Come on, what the meaning of it? Compiler feels A is a variable. If you want to consider a character as a char type in Java, you must include that character either in single, that character must be stored inside single quote. Now it is allowed. Okay, now next. Now I'm writing char ch equal to 1. I have written, is it allowed? One I have written, is it allowed? It is allowed. What happened? Background, one ASCII number, one ASCII character, one is a number, it's ASCII character is stored. No, I want to store one as a one. Okay, I want to store one as a one, then place in single quote. Okay, now it is also allowed. Here what is stored? One ASCII character stored. And here what is stored? One is stored as character, not as a number. Next, tell me, char ch equal to single quote some special character at the rate, is it allowed to store? Okay, without single quote. Without single quote allowed? No. Compiler will throw error. Next, can I store char ch equal to in a single quote? Yes. Sorry, single quote A, single quote A. Is it allowed? Allowed. Okay, now I'm writing char ch equal to empty single quote. Is empty single quote allowed? No. Empty single quote not allowed. Okay, not allowed. Compiler will throw error. Empty char literal. Okay, next, can I write char ch equal to with space? With space allowed? Yes, allowed. Okay, now that means what do you understand here? At least one character must be there in a single quote. Next, tell me, I am writing like this, is it allowed or not? Char ch equal to, I am writing 97, allowed? Allowed. What is stored? Single quote A is stored. Okay, what is stored? Single quote A is stored. Next, I am writing here char ch equal to single quote 97. I am writing, is it allowed? In single quote char ch equal to single quote AB, I am writing, is it allowed? Char ch equal to single quote at the rate hash, I am writing, is it allowed? Char ch equal to char ch equal to single quote space, I am writing, is it allowed? Not allowed. Array character, it's not characters, it is a character, not characters. Character means only one character, na? Understand? Character means one character. In single quote only one character must be allowed. So finally, what are the points you understand from the char data type? Please read. Any single letter alphabet, single alphabet means nothing but letter, any single letter or digit or special character placed inside single quote is called character. Okay, in a beginning identifier chapter I told you, again I'm repeating, alphabet must not call. Okay, if any English speaker, if you take, we don't, people will not call it as any single alphabet. Tell me what we call A, B, C, D. Generally non-English speakers, we used to call them as alphabets. Okay, A is called alphabet. Okay, alphabets, alphabet wrong. Okay, A, B, C, D, 2, dot, 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 J. All 26 letters are called what? Alphabet. If you remember in Telugu, we call it as Aksharam, Aksharamala, right? In Hindi also we call same, Akshar, Aksharamala, Varnamala, right? That means what? All letters together we call singular word we use. What is that? Alphabet. Alphabet means all 26 letters. Being a non-English native speakers, we have practiced this wrong word with all, okay, with each letter. That is wrong. There is no word called alphabets. That is wrong. Alphabet only. And if you want to refer to A, B, C, in Telugu we call Aksharam, in Hindi we call Akshar, in English we call letter, not alphabet. So intentionally I left this mistake because I also committed mistake. If I write here letter, maybe I forgot to address you. That's why I'm just leaving that alphabet. But now please don't pronounce it as alphabet. You must pronounce it as a letter. Okay. Any single letter A to Z or digit or special character placed inside single quote is called as what? Character. For example, single quote A, single quote 1, single quote at the rate are characters. A1 at the rate are not characters. Every character is by default is treated as a karyotype. To store a single character, we must create char variable, because every character is by default treated as a karyotype. Now, where I can store character in the char variable? For example, char ch1 equal to single quote A, char ch2 equal to single quote 1, char ch3 equal to single quote at the rate. Is it clear? Now, rule, in a single quote, only one character is allowed, only one space is allowed, and empty character is not allowed. Okay, the next, char ch4 equal to single quote AB, not allowed. Char ch5 single quote 10, not allowed. Char ch6 equal to single quote at the rate dollar, not allowed. Char ch7 equal to single quote, not allowed. Char ch8 equal to single quote space single quote, not allowed. Char ch9 equal to single quote, ch8 is allowed, sorry. CH8 is allowed, single space, na? Allowed. Multiple spaces, not allowed. Is it clear to all? This is the information about char data type. Explanation on char data type. Compare with the C language, we will discuss. Then now move here. Class example, I'm taking one small program here to prove. Do you remember how did we prove? Once upon a long, long ago, yesterday. Once upon a time, long, long ago, yesterday. You know, yesterday ended 24 hours completed, na? Right? 24 hours completed. Where is that? Yeah. 24 hours completed. Our brain is now empty. Fresh brain. Every day you will come to class with what? Fresh brain, na? Long, long ago, yesterday, we proved integer data type, default type. And next, floating point data type, default data type. And then now, today, let's continue the same program. Char data type. Below. How we proved char data type? Just let me write here. Now I'm writing directly A I have written. Compiler throwing error, who are you? Not a statement. Okay. I am writing here. Okay, now I'm writing CH equal to A. Compiler throwing error, cannot find symbol, two variables. It is throwing two variables. Cannot find symbol CH, cannot find symbol A. Two variables, compiler throwing error. Then, now I'm writing here, CH is a char type data type, char CH. Then compiler throwing error, then what about A? Okay, A is a what type? Cannot find symbol variable A. Then I should write the statement what? Char CH equal single quote A. Then program compiles successfully. Okay, next. I'm writing here. Char CH 2 equal to 1 I am writing. Allowed or not? Allowed. No problem. Okay. Next. I'm writing here. CH 3 equal to, I'm writing single quote 1. It is also allowed. So like this, remaining test cases you try. I want to prove anything you write in single quote is a char type. Single quote A. Compiler will throw error. Illegal start of double equal to coming, right? Control 1, look at here. We are getting compile time error. Char cannot be converted to, char cannot be converted to, where is this? Char cannot be converted to Boolean. Okay, right. Next, can I write empty single quote? Now I'm writing Boolean B2. Yesterday, remember, if you write wrong character, first error is throwing to wrong character, later assignment. Now single quote, it is throwing empty char literal. It's a wrong character. Integer number 2 large we discussed yesterday. Like that empty char literal is a wrong literal. Next, now I'm writing here space, two spaces I'm writing. Then it is throwing error. Unclosed char literal. Unclosed char literal. Okay, this is what? Unclosed char literal started but not closed. Okay, right. So like this, you are going to get errors. So I need to practice. Now, I want you also practice with the overloading point of view. So that overloading point of view, you can answer directly here. No need to type the program. You have that much capacity to answer correctly. Below, M1 of 1, which parameter method executed? Int or char? Why? 1 is of what type? Int. If you write in single quote, then it is a char. Okay, some people are telling care in a deep sleeping mode seems to be. Ray, 4 o'clock, deep sleeping mode is danger. Wake up and tell me, M1 of 1. Tell me, 1 is of what type? Int parameter method executed. M1 of single code 1, what type? M1 of single code 1 is what type? Care parameter. M1 of A, what type? M1 of A, what type? It is A. A is what type? Int type. Oh, chopajare. It is not single quote. Come on, get up. Bring some water, mug of water or bucket of water. Okay. Throw on your face so that you will get out from the wake up mode, sleeping mode. You will be coming from the sleeping mode out. It is A. Are Bujji. Aha. Tirupati is telling it's a bite, sir. Super marvelous, you people are wonderful. That's why your batch, I love you too much. Whatever I am telling you, never listen. Whatever you like, you will keep tell. Okay, that's why your batch is wonderful batch. I love your batch. Whatever I am telling you, never accept. whatever you like, you will keep on throwing your answers on my face and torturing me like anything. Yay, Yaman of yay. Just now answer, just now explain. Just now answer, just now explain what is A. If you don't write in A, single code, if you don't write A in single code, it is considered as a variable. It is a compile time error. Cannot find symbol variable. Just now explain, my dear Gajani. Gajani, number one Gajani. 1 minute Gajani. Our movie Gajani is now 15 minutes Gajani. Mn of a, a is a variable, compiler throw error. 97 int, int parameter method executed. Mn of single quote a, now it is considered as a character. Then what is executed? Char parameter method executed. Int parameter, char parameter, compile time error, int parameter, char parameter. If I write double quotes 10, I mean mn single quote 10, if I write mn single quote 10, which parameter method executed? Character parameter method executed. I know. Cheppanu kada. You are the most worst people in the world. Most number one Gajanis in the world. In a single code, how many characters are allowed? How many characters I have placed? There is one character now, sir, 10 na. If you write outside, that is a 10. If you write in single quote, each one is considered as a character. 1 or 0. Compiler throw error. You never listen whatever I am telling. Badithi puja. Okay, dabidi dibidi for me, no doubt. Whatever I am telling, you never accept. Always you will tell whatever you like. Andar array, you have the more bhajan array. Next topics, you know, more torture topics are coming. Compile. Mn of 10, is it compiled? Yes. Which parameter method executed? Int parameter method is executed. Okay. All you understand? Now the question, how the year 1 is allowed, sir? I told you this one is allowed because character range, character data type, char data type range is number range. Okay, it accepts numbers. What numbers? Can it accept any number range? No. Is integer number, integer type number range. It accepts 0 to 65,535. Between this range, you can assign any number to the char data type. Then its associated matched value will be stored. Understand? Its associated match value will be stored. Is it clear? Remember this. For future, it is this point is required, okay? For future, this point is required. Then, now moving to the next. Compared to C language, in Java, char data type size is 2 bytes. Java char data type is used to represent Unicode character set. What is the Unicode character set range? 0 to 65,535. To represent this huge range number, we need 2 bytes. Understand? We need memory size is what? 2 bytes memory size is required. So that's why charAt data type in Java takes 2 bytes. Whereas in C language, charAt data type range is 0 to 255. That means only 1 byte range value sufficient. Okay, Unicode character set range is 0 to 65,535, which occupies 2 bytes memory. C language charAt data type size is 1 byte. Because C language supports only ASCII character set, which contains 0 to 255 characters. Hence, 1 byte memory is sufficient. Are you catching my point? Java supports Unicode character set for developing internationalization. What the meaning of Unicode character set? Why Java required Unicode character set? Java wanted to support Unicode character set for developing internationalization application. What the meaning of internationalization application? If you now observe, every website is showing the characters in their native language, in the reader native language. You can choose Telugu, Hindi, Marathi, Odia, whichever your regional language, you can choose that one and you can read. If you go to Japan, now every characters in any web, in every website will be displayed on website, on a browser in Japanese language. In China, Chinese language. Are you catching my point? If you wanted to display the website content, website characters on browser, in that country native language, then we have to support Unicode character set. Is it clear to everyone? I18 an application means it should display content in the current country native language in which it is running. So every web application development supporting language will support I18n. Every web application developing programming language must support I18, an internationalization application. To support that language, Unicode character set support is required. This is the basic idea about charAt data type. Can hope everyone got clarity? These are the points related to charAt data type and its comparison. Shall I go to the next point? What is the next data type? What is the next data type? Boolean. Now, Java also supports one special data type called Boolean for representing conditional or logical values, true and false. In a program, to store true and false, we must use Boolean data type variable as shown below. Boolean BO1 equal to true, Boolean BO2 equal to false. Here we need to understand one point. Integer data, floating point data, character data are meant for storing data and perform some calculations. Okay, addition, subtractions, multiplications, divisions. Okay, some calculations we wanted to perform. For that we need what? Integer, floating point, character data. But come to Boolean, it is not meant for performing calculations. Boolean is meant for performing validations. If the given value is right, execute this block of logic. If the given value is wrong, execute another block of logic. To take the decision which block of statements must execute, how many times to execute, to take the decision, we need what? Boolean value. So in general, we use Boolean value for checking condition. It is mainly used in if block, while block, for block, execution. Okay, for block, for executing a block of statements, either 0 to 1 time or 0 to n times. Generally, we don't write the statements like this. Boolean BO equal to true, Boolean BO2 equal to false. Generally, we don't use true and false for storing, rather we will use for checking condition. If true, while true, for true, like this. Understand what is a Boolean data type, what are its values, and where Boolean data type is used. If you take integer, you have range. If you take floating point, we have different range values. If you take If you take what you call a character, we have some range value, but a boolean has only two values, true and false. Apart from true and false, anything you assign to boolean variable, compiler will throw error. Let us try to test these points. Test 0, 4, 5, 0, 5. All these points you must remember. I'm writing boolean BO1 equal to true. Allowed. Control 1, compile. Okay, next. Boolean BO2 equal to false. Control 1, compile. Okay. I want to prove that true is a boolean type. How? Int I1 equal to true USA. Compiler will throw error. Incompatible types. Boolean cannot be converted to int. Okay. Boolean cannot be converted to int. Okay. I have a question. Try to think. Now, I will take one variable, int a equal to 10. I will write one statement here. If a equal to 10, then execute one block of statement, system.out.println, double quotes, I say hi or whatever. Else, execute hello. Hello, chelo, whatever your wish. Compile. What the output will come? Hi, hello world. Understand? So if you wanted to verify some condition, we're using if block and want to execute some block of statements, then we should use boolean. I'm writing 20. Then what will be executed? Else block will be executed. Hello is executed. Can I hope it's understand to all? Then there is a small twist to you. Observe. I am writing boolean BO3 equal to 1. Boolean BO4 equal to 0. Are these allowed or not allowed? Boolean BO3 equal to 1. Boolean BO4 equal to 0. Are these allowed or not allowed? Not allowed. Compiler will throw error. Look at that. Incompatible types. Int cannot be converted to boolean. Incompatible types, int cannot be converted to boolean. In C language, it is allowed. In C language, one means true, zero means false. Where? In C language. Okay, in C language, not one, any positive number. One or any positive number is a true. Zero means false. This is the generally C language following terminology. But in Java, if you follow it, compiler will throw error. Java compiler doesn't accept. C compiler accepts, but Java compiler doesn't accept. It will throw error. Then tell me, I am writing if. If is need to take the decision. If true, execute this block. If false, don't execute this block. That is the decision. Can I write one here? Bolo. Can I write if one here? If I write if one, compiler will throw error. Okay, incompatible types. Int cannot be converted to boolean. If argument is what type? Boolean type. If I write if one, compiler will throw error. Incompatible types. Okay, same way. Can I write if false? If zero? No. Compiler will throw error. I have to uncomment it. It will throw error. Okay, based on this point, I wanted to test one small point. Let me see how many people can answer. Int I1 equal to, I'm taking some value 5. Okay, if I1 equal to 5, open bracket, system.out.println. Now I'm writing double quotes, in if. Okay, else, open bracket, closed bracket. I'm writing here. System.out.println in else. Bolo, what is the output you'll get? In if or in else? What output you'll get? In if or in else? Excellent. Wonderful. Okay. Some people are telling in if, some people are telling in else. Excellent. Marvelous. Super. Bumper. Wonderful. Both. Okay. Babu, who are you? Who are you, Nana? Are you both? Are you boy or girl or both? If condition, if I take, how both executed? Are you kidding with me? Are you kidding? If you kidding with me, I will come back with you, okay? You will commit suicide with my statements. Be careful, okay? Are you catching my point? I am more far senior to you, okay? Already did all this nonsense with my faculties, with my seniors, with my juniors. You are after all bacha in front of me, okay? So answer to the question. If I also. Compiler throw error. Why? Compiler throw error. Not if, not else. Compiler throw error. Why? What operator I have used here? It is not double equal to. It is assign operator. What it will do? It will copy this 5 into I1 variable, replace with 5. Okay. Then what is the value going to if 5? To the if, number is allowed or not allowed? In C language, allowed. In Java, not allowed. In Java, it will throw compile time error. Look at that. Int cannot be converted to Boolean. Then what should I use here? I must use here I1 double equal to 5. Now, error or no error? No error. Is 5 is now copying into I1? No. I1 is comparing with 5. Now it is true. Then output is in if. All you understand? Okay. Again, I'm asking question. Here you got error. Is it because of assignment operator or is it because of expression value is int? Here you need to be very careful. Like yesterday, integer number too large. Here the problem with assignment operator, result is a result value type. Okay. Now tell me, Boolean. BO 5 equal to, I'm writing true, okay? And then I'm writing, if BO 5 equal to true, okay? Then system.out.println, system.out.println, double quotes, in if, else, system.out.println, double quotes in else. Bolo. Now, what is the output? Compile time error. What is the output? Compile time error. Now, what is the output? Compile time error. No error. Output is in if will come. Compile, execute. In if. So, don't show your wrong talent. Okay? That's what I'm telling you. Our batch students are great people. They never try to understand what I am trying to explain. They will come with their own doubts. They will throw their own questions. Okay? They will use their own brain. Problem is not with the assignment operator. Problem is with result. This is an expression. Here assignment operator, what is doing? Copying the value 5 into I1 variable and taking result what 5. result is 5. You have to concentrate on expression result. Result is 5. Okay? 5 is not accepted by if, that's why throwing error. Then here also I have used assignment operator. But I'm not getting error. Why? I'm not getting error here. Why? Because true is a copy into Boolean variable. Okay? True is copy into Boolean variable. And then this expression replace with what value? True. Okay? This expression is replaced with what value? True. If true, accepted or not? Yes. That's why no error. Is it clear? So assignment is not the problem. Result is coming what? That is the problem. Did you understand? Write directly. I have written directly for your clarity. But in project always we write true? No. We will generate the true based on the condition like this. Then which operators will generate the Boolean value? We have 40 operators in Java. How many operators? 40 operators are there in Java. In that 40 operators, we have to use three categories of operators to generate Boolean value. In projects, we don't directly place Boolean values true, false in if, while, for conditions as shown in above code. Rather, we will place an expression that generates Boolean value true, false dynamically with the input, with the given input values. Understand? Then to generate Boolean values dynamically inside an expression, we must use Boolean value generating operators such as relational operators, less than zero, less than greater than, less than or equals to, greater than or equals to, instance of. Equality operators, double equal to, not equal to. Logical operators, double and double R. Okay, only these three operators we must use in the condition section. For example, void among index, if x equal to 10, tell me, this is an assignment operator or equality operator? Equality operator, generating Boolean true, false. If x value 10, true. If x value not equal to 10, false. Then else you can use less than operator also. Next point. Boolean data type is used in validations or verifications, but not in calculations. Already told you. It means to confirm the given value input is correct or wrong, we will use Boolean data type value. Whereas byte, short, int, long, float, double, char data types are used in calculations to generate output value from the given inputs. For example, class addition int a. If a less than 0, look at here. Here Boolean data used for validation. System.out.println don't pass negative number. Else system.out.println a plus 20. Here plus operator generating what? Int data type calculation purpose. Is it clear my point? Boolean data type is always used in condition, in association with condition, and remaining data types are used in the calculation point of view. So this is a very important point. Please remember for future. Now comparison with C. Like in C language, in Java, we cannot use 0 as false and 1 as true. Java compiler will throw error. For example, if 0, if 1. In C language, we are allowed. But in Java, not allowed. Okay, now? Already comfortable with the Boolean data type? Tell me, what is the output of this program? Once again, testing same program. What is the output of this program? Compile time error. Why compile time error? Because assignment operator, because result. Here result is generating int. If int not allowed. Okay. It is a assignment operator, not comparison operator. Because it is assignment operator, 10 copy into x and what value given to if? 10 giving. If 10 not allowed. Then if I take a double equal to operator, then comparison happening. Comparison means what? It is not copying. Reading the x value and comparing with the 10. If yes, true, s opening high. If no, false. So m1 of 10 high, m1 of 20, hello. Any doubts? Junior NTR. Any doubts? Did you watch that movie? Yamadonga? In that movie, he will tell a big statement, big dialogue. And last, he says, any doubts? Boolean data, so many points we discussed. So finally, any doubts? Now I'm entering the next data type. Ready? Horrible data type. Now I'm playing with you like anything. Ready na? What is this concept? A equal to 20, same thing. If I write a boolean, compile through error. If I write true, then tell me. A equal to false, I have written. Any compile time error? What is the output of this program? A equal to int, A equal to 10, compile time error. I'm writing boolean, A equal to true, and 20 place I'm writing false. Any compile time error? No compile time. Output will be? Hello. Okay. And A value will be? Here if I write system.out.println a value will be true or false? False. Because false copy into A na. Next horrible data type, string data type. Ready na? Bah. Now the string data type we will play with you like anything. Ready? Identifier chapter is coming back again. Test 06. Yesterday I told you join C language. Any of you attended C language demo class today morning at 9 o'clock? If you want to be strong in logical programming, C language knowledge is compulsory. Okay, Kishore sir, starting C language at morning 9 o'clock and evening 6 o'clock CRT batch is there. Okay, C, CRT, Core Java, you will learn parallel. CRT, you will learn formulas. What we call formulas and mathematical calculations. Then in C language, you learn how to convert that mathematical formulas and calculation as a program, because in future, you need to do that programming only now. Then following by in Java, I will teach you how to develop that mathematical programs as object-oriented programming. Okay, na? So, requesting you all, compulsory join C language and compulsory join CRT. C, CRT, Core Java will definitely change your depth of the programming. Okay? And now come to the story now. In a main method, I'm going to write something like this. Is it allowed or not? String S1 equal to Hari. String S1 equal to Hari, I have written. Is it allowed? String S1 equal to Hari. Allowed or not allowed? Not allowed. Why? Like character, Hari is also must be placed in quotes. Character must be placed in single quote and Hari must be placed in double quote. Is it clear? Then listen carefully. If you place a letter or a word directly, compiler will throw error. Compiler consider the letter and word as a variable. Cannot find symbol variable Hari. If you want to ask compiler and JVM treat it as a word, then what do you write? If you want to tell to compiler and JVM treat as a word, not as a variable, you must write in double quotes. Now accept. Compile successfully. Very understand? So final conclusion, tell me. For storing a word, a text data, a word in Java, we have a predefined class called java.lang.string. Now tell me, string is what? A data type now. Why class? Class is a data type now. We have a predefined class called string. Now this class string you can use to create a variable to store data. So any single character or multiple characters placed in double quote will be considered as a java.lang.string type. To store in Java, we must create a variable of what type? String. How can I prove it? Simple. Int I1 equal to double quote say, if you write, compiler will throw error. Babu, double quote say is string type. String cannot be converted to int. Got clarity? Double quote say is by default considered as string. Okay, fine. Then now try to answer these points. Now simple. String is a referenced data type. String is also a data type. It is a referenced data type. In reference data type, we have two, array and class. Now string is a class. It is a class. It is a predefined class created by Sun. It is available in java.lang.package, in java.base module, in JDK software. So like string, how can I create our own data type? That we'll discuss today and tomorrow. Don't worry. Okay, I will show you how to create. Next, tell me. It is used for representing sequence of characters placed in double quote. It means for storing a sequence of characters as one group, we must create string class type referenced variable as shown below. String S1 equal to double quotes Hare Krishna. Now it is a string. Rule. If you want a compiler and JVM treat a sequence of characters as a string type, you must place them inside double quotes. If you use a sequence of character directly in a program, compiler will treat it as a string. Compiler will not treat it as a string, throws error. For example, string S1 equal to Hare Krishna, if you write, it is not a string, compiler throw error. Bujji, all the people understand 3 points? Then tell me, in a double quotes, how many characters I can place? In a double quotes, string S3 equal to, I can place 0 to n number of characters. Look at there, no compile time error. 0 you can place. You can place one space. I have to take it as a S4. Now look at there, double quotes, right? And then now three spaces allowed. Okay, I have to change the variable name. Yeah. Let me remove this. S4 only repeatedly I'm using. Okay. Now look at their compile and executed. I am writing some letter, single letter allowed. Okay. I'm writing two letters allowed. I want to store alphanumeric 123 at the rate hash dollar allowed. Okay. Now, when we want to store a name or a course or a department, or alphanumeric number like PAN number, engine number, bike number, we must use string data type variable like this. String name equal to HK, string course equal to Java, string bike company name equal to Bajaj, engine number equal to ABC123PQ, bike number equal to TS09BJ99999. Next, inside double quotes, we can use 0 or n number of characters, means an empty string is also allowed. Double quotes, empty double quotes. Now, double quotes, space, double quotes. Compared to C language, in C language also we have string concept, I hope, right? Compared to C language, in Java, we don't have empty character, null characters, not there. Okay, in C language, generally people say that at last null character, what the null character? /0. At last /0 will be there. Okay, they used to tell something like this. But in Java, we do not have null character. We don't have any additional characters in Java. Just remember it. Don't compare with C language. The most horrible point. Are you ready? Observe. Am I allowed to create a variable with the name string? I'm writing like this. Int string equal to 10. Am I allowed to write? Can I use a predefined class name as my user defined identifier? Identifier chapters I have explained. So you listen and forgot. Everyone is telling no. Okay, I'm telling now. Next coming chapters you will show chukkala to me. Stars, daytime only will show stars to me, no doubt. Wonderful batch, the great wonderful batch. Topic is every day coming, completing, topics are completing, we are moving to the next topics. And You people are not practicing. Only few people are giving correct answer. Remaining all people are whatever they like, they are giving. So even one second time also not taking, you know. Question fully not completed, answers are coming. No. Yes. How? Where? Why? Whatever they like, they will answer. One second also don't think. String is a predefined class name. Can I use a predefined class name, variable name, method name as an identifier? Identifier chapter 7 rules I explained. Keywords and reservoirs we cannot use. Keywords and identifier, keywords and reservoirs we cannot use. Predefined class name and variable names, method names, we can use as a predefined identifier. That they are clearly shown in the system. Clearly compiled, executed, show you every point, notes I type, dictated, material given. Today again you are giving wonderful answer, no, not allowed. But compiler telling allowed. Because your world is different, compiler world is different. You never come to my world, you never come to compiler world. You be in your own world only. Your father is having wonderful money. This COVID time also is having so much of money. That's why he paid and joined you in the class. That's it, na? Okay, payment completed. Now relax, happily relax. Now come on, remaining people who are giving right answer, tell me now. Here if you write system.out.println, system.out.println, system.out.println string below, will you get output as a string or will you get output as a 10? Come on, come on. We'll get output as 10. No compile time error and no runtime error. We'll get output 10. Now listen carefully and tell me. I'm writing int system equal to 20. Int system equal to 20. Is it allowed or not? Now come on. At least now all you people give correct answer. You know people, I have been in very much disappointed in your batch. Every day I'm trying to come back with the original HK style. I'm trying to bring back my original style. So it is in your hand. If you practice well and come back, I am ready to teach in HK style. Otherwise, I'll show you torture, no doubt. Already you have seen, already you have tasted. So come back with practice. Every day horrible points will be there. Torture points will be there. You will get blood tears. Rakta kanniri you will get. Next classes are more danger. More depth classes will come. Okay. So if you don't practice, you will face a lot of problems in the next classes. You joined in my class not for time passing, not for course completion certificate. So many people are asking, sir, will you give course completion certificate? What will you do with that course completion certificate? Only for, you know, lamination purpose only useful. No company will ask, show your Naresh IT course completion certificate. Companies will ask in the interim, show your knowledge. Answer this question, answer that question. Yeah, I completed course completion certificate. I have an HK product. Don't ask any question. Give me job and will not give. HK products are good. Okay. Data type, variable name equal to value. Oh, okay. Now tell me here system equal to 20. What is system? It is a variable name place. Can I use a predefined class name as a variable name? Here the position is what? Variable name position. In a variable name position, can I use a predefined class name? Yes. Any compile time error? No compile time error. Compile successfully. Okay, na? Again repeating, carefully think 1 second and then give answer. Blindly if you give answer, madre. I am writing one statement here, system.out.println of double quotes, hi. Just simply I'm writing hi. Tell me, is this line compiled and executed, output coming hi? What is the output will come? Hi will come, read that line, don't see the line, read that line. If you read that line, then your mind will start work. If you read that line, you will start, your mind will start work. Read loudly, open your mouth. Open your mouth and read loudly, you will get clarity on this line. System dot, hey. Here system, this is Uchi system. When I write this string repeated here, compiler considering this string as a predefined class string or this variable name string, consider as a variable name string, then reading its value 10. Similarly, after this 21 line, if I take a system, compiler by default refers to which variable? This name system by default refers to whom? Predefined class or above variable? It refers to above variable. Then it is verifying system is a variable. In a variable, it is searching for variable. In a variable, variable is not there, na? Okay, now the interviewer will ask the question like this. What is the output of this program? All the people will not see this first system. All the people will see the second system. System equal to 20. Output you are attaining 20. Understand my point? Everybody got clarity, yeah? You have to consider every word, very important. Compiler will throw error. You cannot use the system as an int variable to call out. It will throw in a Java English. Int cannot be dereferenced. Compiler will throw error. Int cannot be dereferenced because system is a variable of what type? Int. Tell me, how can we solve this problem? Come on. How can we solve this problem? I have to smallest. Are you right? Smallest, there is no point of conflict, na, Viru. If you take smallest, there is no conflict of the name, na. I want a name conflict and I want to solve that problem, right? System one, system two. Telling na, you never think as I am thinking. Whatever you like, you will think. Great bachelor. Wow. When you people will change, please think from the interview point of view. You are not solving the current problem. You know, you are telling, no, somebody come to your hospital. You are a, let's say you are a doctor. Somebody coming to you telling that, sir, I'm suffering from stomach pain. Then you are telling that, try to get a headache, na. Huh? Are currently I'm suffering from stomach pain, try to get headache, problem solved. It's a wonderful explanation you will give away. Current problem is a system. How to solve the system and change it name to system one, change to small s. Bangar Kondal Ramiras. You have to tell to compiler, consider the system as a predefined class system. How? By using java.lang.system. And the system will be considered as variable. Control 1, compile. Control 2, 1020. Array, I don't talk to your Tumri fellow. You come first of all with your name. Join the class with your name. Your father, mother given a name to you. But you never join to the class with a name. You are an unknown person, anonymous person. No name, orphan. Main method, SOP len high, no syntax mistakes, program compiled, dot class file created for test 06 dot class. Then tell me, if I run this program, is it executed? Fast, if I run this program, is this program executed? Is this program executed? No. JVM will throw an error saying that main method not found in the class test 06, please define the main method as public static void main of string array args. Right? Mr. JVM, why you confusing? I created same main method only. Main method there na? Right? Copy, delete it, paste. Maybe some characters missing, maybe save it, control one, compile, execute. Right? Same error coming. Public static void main string array args not found there na? Amma Ishika, how the first class is linking? Are you following Java 11 new feature? Java 11 feature running Java file directly by using Java command, then first class should have main method. Then in that case it is throwing error, class string doesn't have main method. Come on. I'll do one thing, for your understanding, I'll do one thing. I will remove this class string. I am deleting this class string. Okay. Control one, compile. Control two, executed. Output coming high. Kaise aa raha hai? Now JVM found main method. Okay. I am placing string class. Control one, compile. Background dot class file create a string dot class. Execute. JVM is throwing exception. JVM is facing some problem with our local string. JVM is facing problem with our local string. Oh, this local string creating some problem. Here this string is local string. Tomorrow somebody coming to the class and starting the class with the name Hari Krishna. Will you accept that Hari Krishna? To start the class and teach Java? Tomorrow somebody is logging to the Zoom and saying that, hey, this is Hari Krishna, let's discuss what we discussed last class. Will you accept him? Why? Because he is not predefined Hari Krishna, he is local Hari Krishna. That local Hari Krishna voice is different from predefined Hari Krishna voice. We can catch, you are not seeing my face, but you are seeing, you are listening my voice, you habituated with my voice. Even while sleeping also my voice is coming, Tumri fellow, get up, go and practice. Thank you sir, okay, going. So my voice is fully feeded in your mind. Right? Are here JVM not looking for local string. JVM main method parameter is what? java.lang.string predefined. Okay, predefined string it is java.lang. Now program is compiled, executed, and output coming hi. Hello. Look at there. Main method is there, local string is there, but still program successfully compiled and executed. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Output coming hi. Tell me, if I create variable as the name string, no problem. But if you use class name as a string, then in this folder, all Java files compilation done, but no class is executed. Sometimes students are calling me after this data type chapter completed. Then people who practiced, they started sending messages to me, sir. Till yesterday, classes are run, sir, but today not running. Why, sir? I don't understand. What happened in my system, sir? Virus came in your system. What is that virus? String dot class. Okay, na? The virus is string dot class. I used to ask that student, "Arey, go to the folder and verify. Is there any string dot class file?" Yes, sir. Available. Delete it. Deleted. And then now you run. Then after deleting and running whatever I have explained the previous class, now those points will come to their mind. Okay, sir. Okay. I recollected yesterday. You told you all this point. Why that fellow forgot this point? lack of practice. Immediately, if you practice, make a notes by your own running notes is very, very important. If you write your own running notes, everything will be remembered in your mind. Otherwise, you will forget the points easily. Is it clear? So tell me, whenever you see, array my class, why not executing even though main method is available, immediately add java.lang, it will start executing. Find, is there any local class or some Java file is there outside, delete them, it will work. Okay, now I'm continuing one more quiz. Are you ready? One second. I want to show you one point. I'm deleting this local class, deleting this dot class file, and then deleting array. Deleting this java.lang also. Then in this case, there is no error. Why? There is no error. Compiled successfully, executed successfully. Why? Because implicitly, compiler software will add java.lang behalf of you. Are you catching my point? If you place local class string here, if you place local class string, compiler software linking this string to local class, and compiler software not placing java.lang. Look at there. Compiler software not placing java.lang for your class. Everybody got clarity? Yeah? Because compiler is not placing, JVM throwing error. Then you yourself has to place java.lang. Understand a predefined compile generated code. Compile successfully. How to see the compiler generated bytecode? Yesterday shown you Java P command. I configured Java P command in edit plus. You also configure. Look at there. Now we placed, it is coming. So JVM executing it. So tell me, what is the full prototype of main method? Tell me what the full syntax of main method? Public static void main of java.lang.string. For a compiler, you can give string, compiler will add java.lang. But for JVM, you must add what? Full java.lang. If compiler not adding, you have to add explicitly. Can I hope all you people got clarity on this point? Very tricky interview question it is. Very, very important interview question it is. Okay, now I want to ask another question. Look at here. I am writing some statement here, Adhyaksha. String S1 equal to double quotes Hari. Is it compiled? Please think 1 second and give answer. Don't blindly give answer. Fast, don't give Ravava. Are you, how many years of experience you have to give answer that much fast? As if you are the James Kosling, you are giving answer. As if you are the inventor of the Java language, you are giving answer. Are you, 1 second also you are not thinking away. Compile or not compile? It is not compiled. Compiler throw error. Incompatible types. At least by seeing error, you understand yourself. I don't explain. You yourself understand because you are not using your brain. Then I don't use my mouth. Are I told you na, Hari is what type? Double quotes is what type? Predefined a class string. You assign to whom now? S1 variable of what type? Local class. This is real Hari Krishna me. And this is duplicate Hari Krishna, my dupe. Can I assign real Hari Krishna to dupe? No, na? Then how to solve this problem? By using java.lang.explicitly. Come on, buddy. Start work. Start think. Compile successfully now. Executed successfully. Okay. You have to, here also you should write what? java.lang. Come on, start think, okay? How many days more you will answer wrong answers? Come on, start think correctly. Tell me. Now bringing this statement to here, okay? Now what am I doing first? I am removing this java.lang. Removing this local class. Removing this local class. Removing this string.class file. Come back. Compile. Look at there. Compile, then control 3, compile successfully, control 3, look at here, compiler software has added java.lang. Do you understand my point? Compiler software has added implicitly java.lang. Why? because there is no class called string found in the current directory. If I place local string, compiler will throw error linking this string to local string. Okay, then how to solve this problem? I myself should add what? Java dot lang dot string. Now problem solved. Be careful, this practice is necessary. So now try to answer all questions. Are you ready? All are ready to answer my questions? I'm removing this local string. Okay, after testing, remove the local string, otherwise you will face problem. Now I'm trying to ask the questions. Try to answer. Can I use predefined class name as the variable name as an identifier? Yes. If I create a variable name as a system, any compile time error? No. But in the next lines, if I use system.out.println, we will get compile time error. How to solve that compile time error? By using fully qualified name, package name dot class name, java dot lang dot system. Next, can I create my own class with the name string? Yes. Then wherever you have used the string, compiler link that one with our local class string. Then what is the solution to this problem? If you want to access predefined class, you must use java.lang.string. If I create a local class, if you create a local class string in your folder, main method is not executed in all classes because compiler linking main method to the local class string, but JVM is looking for predefined class. All you people understand? Then how to solve this problem? You have to use java.lang.string. Okay. Now finally, I'm writing one statement, sir. Observe. String equal to double quotes string. Is it allowed? String equal to double quotes string. Is it allowed? Tell me, it is compiled is successful, no problem. Here, double quotes string is what? Literal of what type? Predefined class java.lang.string. Here, assignment operator before string is what? Class name or variable name? It is a variable name. And then here, this string is what? Here, this string is what? It is a data type. Now tell me, any compile time error? No compile time error. Here string refers to what? Variable. What that variable? String. String value is what? String. Output is what? String. String equal to string. What is displayed? String. Hello, this string is which string? First string or second string or third string? Value string. Okay, this type of questions also will come in the interview. If you practice, you will get clarity. If you don't practice, somebody is telling that bounce, sir. When it is bouncing, you play hook shot, nana. Okay? Play hook shot or pull shot. Right? You don't know cricket? Ay-ay-ay-ay-ay. Okay? Learn how to play cricket, okay? When it is bouncing, what you do? Call AB de Villiers. Okay, call AB de Villiers. He will teach you how to play hook shot, pull shot. Rohit Sharma, call Rohit Sharma also. Tell me, note, we are allowed to create our own class with the name string. If we create our own class with the name string, we must access predefined class string with its name, fully qualified name. It means we must access it by using its package name. For example, in D drive core Java data types folder, I created a string.java file with the class string allowed. In a test.java, if you write string s1 equal hk, compiler throw error incompatible types, because hk is a java.lang.string and we cannot assign to s1 variable because s1 is looking like a string, but which string it is? Local string. Then how can we solve above line error? You have to take string as what type? java.lang. Then problem solved. And next, if you define main method, then what happened? Main method is never executed. What the solution? You have to place java.lang.string in main method. So these are the points. Practice in your system, then it will remember, then you will understand. Some points definitely you don't understand. Some points you will come to know, oh, these are the points are there. People who are from the day beginning practicing a lot of the classes, people who are responding in the classes, they will immediately catch the point and they will continue. People who are not practicing along with the class, following not the faculty, then whenever this type of depth confusions are coming, they will cry. Obviously, points will be bouncing on your head. So how to catch those bouncing points? By practice. Go to room, open the system, type, you will face the problem, your mind will start working. Then finally, every data type is having a fixed data type and range. Then what is the string data type size? What the range? String is a reference data type. Reference data type has size and range depending on number of characters I told you, na? In a double quotes, how many characters used, that is the size. Size is number of characters into 2, because every character occupies 2 bytes of memory. And range, no limit. In a double quotes, you can write any number of characters. You can store any number of characters. And it's a default value. Every data type has a default value. And string variable default value is null. N-U-L-L, null. Remember it. Okay? These are the points related to string. Next, remember string is not always predefined class. The name string will be considered as a predefined class as long as we not create our own class with the name string. If we create our own class with the name string, then the class name string will be refers to our local class string, but not predefined class. If you want to refer to predefined class string, we must explicitly use the class name as java.lang.string. Hence, we can say the statement, string s1 equal Hari is not compiled always, and public static one string array args will not be executed always. java.lang.string s1 equal Hari and public static void main java.lang.string array args are always compiled and executed. Just me tested. All these points are there in Xerox material. Check. This is the conclusion. Data types, mathematics and Java data types matching. In maths, we have integers, floating points, characters, conditional string. Then to represent them, in our Java language, we have data types, int, double, char, boolean, java.lang.string. In our projects, 99% we will use int, long, double, char, boolean, and string only. Okay? Right. So this knowledge is very much important to everyone. I hope all the people got some idea. Verify in the textbook all points are there or not. Whatever I explained. Yesterday page number continue. You must use cast operator, Madhuri. If you want to execute char data type parameter method by passing 97, you must use a cast operator. Before 97, you should write char of 97. Okay, Madhuri, understand? Okay, so final conclusion, once again I'm repeating, need of this chapter. In this chapter, our target is, in a RAM memory, in a program, I want to create memory to store data. The data can be integer data, floating point data, character data, now what you call a boolean data, one value I want to store, then create a primitive variable by using the data type. I want to store any of the values of multiple values of same type, create array object. I want to store multiple values of different type, then you should use class object. Okay, these are all the points you need to know related to all the data types. And string data type, last one is a confusion. If you practice, you will understand, sir. If you don't practice, lifelong you will have confusion. And a string as a predefined class, system as a predefined class, and user defined class, the differentiation entry questions will come in the written test exam. Practice today, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me tomorrow. Okay, so that's all for the day. I hope today class you enjoyed and little bit not enjoyed. Today I scolded you intentionally to warn you, you have to practice. Yesterday I didn't scold because you people are in a good flow, because yesterday points nothing new, all are simply theory points. Once the programming started, now you are committing mistake because lack of practice. So please try to practice and come tomorrow. It's very, very important. Okay, tomorrow class, too much peaks you enjoy. Tomorrow class is variables topic. Okay. Tomorrow we are going to talk about variables. Okay, completed. Need of the chapter, what is a data type and why data type? Types of data types and their purpose. Explain why do we have 8 primitive data types and 5 reference data types. Explanation on each data type, comparison with C language. In C language, I hope string is not there. In C language, to store characters, we use char array. Right? Char array we use. Okay, fine. The next. When we should use a data type, sir? Last point, sixth point. Can you answer? When we must use a data type? We must use a data type wherever value representation is there. Wherever value is need, there we will use data type. Yes or no? For example, a value will be used at 3 places. For creating variable, for creating parameter, and for creating return type. Okay, when should we use a data type? For creating variable, for creating parameter, for creating return type. Wherever value presence is there data type is required. Storing value int x equal to 10. Passing and receiving a value as argument parameters. And returning a value from the method return type. Okay, now this point is not there in the material. Please take screenshot and make a note in your material. Okay, so that's all for today class, and tomorrow we will start the very interesting horrible story. What is a variable, problem of variable, array, problem of array, and then class, advantage of class. These 7 to 13 points are the most interesting points. Okay, wonderfully you will enjoy. So this is my favorite topic. Okay, 7 to 13 topics are my favorite. So don't miss tomorrow class. Tomorrow class, we are entering into object-oriented programming. Don't miss tomorrow class. And reminding all the people, so please plan to join CRT 6-8 by Hari Krishna Sagar sir, 7-9 Kishore sir, C language. Then you will be in a good flow with the Java. So you will start getting lot of ideas of writing program, lot of logical programming will be improved. You know, almost, you know, all companies have started functioning normally. COVID lockdown over. Now, experienced people are getting huge openings. You know, experienced people who are applying jobs with a 2+, that per day they are getting. Then tell me, you will be getting job with.